Bloomberg is a company that's built on communication. So it was incredibly thrilling to be able to work with experts, archaeologists, linguists, and conservators to help bring to life some communications really from 2,000 years ago. Through the writing tablets, we've been able to uncover some extraordinary information. Facts about day-to-day transactions, thoughts, deeds, even the names of some of the Roman predecessors that have inhabited the site. It's been a process that's really enabled us to hear the voices of the very first Londoners.
Taurus Macrinodon
Atticus
Decimus Aletius is to be given to Ingenius provision for to him to the matter.
You never know quite what you're going to find with archaeology. We were hopeful with the Bloomberg site because it's right in the heart of the Roman city of London. We knew from the site next door that a wooden writing tablet had been found, and we were hopeful that we might get some more on the Bloomberg site. Maybe 3 or 4. But what we actually found completely blew us away. We hand excavated over 3,500 tons of soil from the site, within which we found evidence of over 50 Roman buildings, 15,000 Roman artifacts. But the most significant collection of things within that are the stylus writing tablets. we found over 400 writing tablets, more than doubled the number we have from London. It's absolutely incredible. One of the tablets is the earliest financial document from the City of London. It's essentially one merchant asking to be paid his 105 denarii for goods delivered. It's dated to the 8th of January 57 AD.
We know that London was totally destroyed by Boudicca, so was St. Albans Verulamium in the year 61. And yet we find within a year or 2 years, one businessman writing to another, he's undertaking to deliver 20 loads of foodstuffs from Verulamium. It does show a very rapid recovery. That's an unexpected detail to find among the tablets.
One of the most exciting tablets is an address. It dates from about 65 to 70 AD, and it says Londinio Mogontius, to Mogontius in London. It's the first time we have London mentioned ever in history. One of the most wonderful things about the collection is that we have over 100 names of people that actually lived in London at the time. There's one tablet which refers to Julius Classicus, a figure known from Roman history, who was in the 6th cohort of the Nervians.
Classicus is a well-known figure who ultimately turns out to be a revolt again Rome 10 years later. Then there's Junius the Cooper, who was making the barrels for the beer, presumably. Cooper, from the word Cooper, meaning a cask.
There's the judge, who's calling people to a pre-trial hearing.
The two people concerned, Litigainus and Magunus, are not Roman citizens. The Roman government, if you like, providing a framework whereby probably Gallic businessmen can settle a dispute before a Roman court. Using the evidence from the Bloomberg site, we can reconstruct a number of stages in making these tablets. The writing tablets from Bloomberg were made in the shape of a small tile, very thin. They had a sunken area in the middle to contain the wax on which people wrote, scribing lines through the wax, which reveals the pale of wood underneath.
The wax that was originally in the tablets, not there anymore. So what we're looking for are the tiny little scratches which would be left after somebody'd written the message with the stylus.
Well, these documents written in is what we call cursive, which is simply a grand term for a running hand. I picked out about 100 tablets. They were then passed on to Andy and his team. They took for me a series of photographs. What we're trying to produce with light from different directions is to show in as contrasty manners as possible. Shadows falling into fine lines cut into the surface of the timber. So you have a series of photographs taken with the diagonal breaking light. You can combine these photographs. I do it in a fairly simple way, partly tracing, partly drawing. You have to have an imagination, but you must control it very rigidly.
I don't think there's any kind of computer software that can replace what Roger does, because it's a massive combination of knowledge, experience of years and years of looking at these tablets. It's incredible. I can best describe it as code breaking.
Just the fun of deciphering puzzles. I do a lot of Sudoku and code word and that sort of thing. Then there's the hopes of finding answers to questions about what was going on in the very first years of Roman London.
Our other main objective, as well as deciphering the tablet, was to preserve them for the future. Preserving this object is incredibly important because of the future academic research that might be done on them. Anything we do now will affect what kind of information can be obtained in the future. You make Caesar's very much as the guardian of the site. We believe passionately in the importance of conserving and protecting not only the objects, but also the information that has been uncovered through this process. We also feel very strongly about giving back to our local community, about sharing the knowledge for the benefit of future generations. And it's also giving people the opportunity to hear those voices of the very first Londoners.